anything in dust in this world. I want to be anything in which I will go and hear all these things. This katha will, this pastime will enter my heart through ears, and I will have all these things. So Hari Katha ki
Jai!
Jai! The okay, pastimes of Krishna, Jai Ho!
Jai!
Jai!
Sadhusang ki
Jai!
Gurudev ki Jai!
But we should try to follow. Certainly we should read and follow. Upadeshamritam.
Nectar of devotion.
No, no, Aprup Goswami.
Nectar of instruction.
Aprup Goswami. You should have that book. Also have Manashiksha.
Of Das Goswami.
Of Das Goswami. And Sisrit Shastaka of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Also the books of Jaiva Dharma, of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Jaiva Dharma. This will make you easily enter in the books of Swamiji like Chaitanya Charitamrita, Srimad Bhagavatam. But first we should try to learn all these books. But explanation are needed to hear from any one of my voices.
Gaur Premanande.
We'll have to leave this place tomorrow in morning. What time?
Breakfast, if you want,
if you can go very early, very good.
Yes.
Also, please meet, and we will try to meet in
London.
The devotees who will go here, and on 4th we will leave
England,
and we will go to
Holland
and
America.
I'm so much. I'm so much indebted to you all, so much that you have given me so much bona fide sadhu sangha. I will never forget you all. When I will return to Vrindavan, also I will remember that.
We will all go there.
I will pray Krishna that I should have the
association
of all the devotees.
Hello.
So if I have done anything wrong, you should try to forgive and forgive me. I may have told so many what kathor baat.
Pinching words.
Krishna is black.
Why? I told so many things. Because black has no color. Black is no color. Actually, scientists have proved. Black is no color. He is above
any color.
Color means trigun, the gun of Maya, the qualities of Maya, sat, raj, tam. We are binding in that thing. Krishna is the Lord, all. So he is black. He is actually not black for what we understand. But he is black, so pitiful. He is not black as anything black in this world. But he is black. But Satchidananda.
That world.
Very beautiful, more than gold, golden color. Uh-huh. But why we chant Gaur Gaur name? Similarly, it is also above all the gunas. But all
aggregate.
All the colors
come together.
Combined.
Come together. Then it becomes Vibhya. Vibhya means? What is the letters there in Vibhya?
Vibhigo.
The letters of Vibhya. How many?
Seven
letters. So all colors. You should write the names of the colors and see that all colors combination. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srimati Radhikaya, go and Krishna.
Sure.
Beyond all the colors. Guru Maharaj told me this thing. Go to
Thank you.
I go to Hari Ki
Jai. I want to give so many thanks to Lalita and
Nanga Mohan.
He was amazing. He has helped us to make this whole house. And he's arranging everything here. He's not so much wealthy, married, not so like a poor. But yet he's managing everything. I also want to give so many thanks to the boy, Salad. He is so energetic. Being a little boy.
He is here. Here is he.
He's talking about you.
And he has managed here and there in his schools and Sanatana Dharma everywhere. So I thank them all. And I will pray to Krishna that he should bestow his mercy to them. They are suffering, all the devotees, making accommodations and so much. I also give so many thanks to all the devotees. If they were not here, I could not have preached. I could not have, in a forest, there is no person to hear. How he can preach? So if you are not all here, how can you have preached? And I need so much energy that being I'm old, but yet I have energy of young persons, getting classes here, there, talking with so many Vaishnavas. So the energy came from you all.
We know you can create a universe.
We want to thank you for coming all the way from India and giving us your wonderful association.
Yes.
And all the energy that we need,
yes,
to go back with you.
Just one announcement. Prem Vilas Prabhu has organized a big house in London so all the devotees can go and stay there.
Yeah.
Where is
Prem?
In London.
They left
London
yesterday.
No, tomorrow afternoon. If the weather is nice, then tomorrow afternoon will be a big Harina in London. We try to go Trafalgar Square, Madison, whatever it is.
What?
Rumbi.
Huh?
Rumbi.
Oh, very tasteful.
Gosh, I need so much care. I saw you. You need so much care. So much love you are giving.
Come here, so the boys stay home.
Oh,
You just got one.
I got two.
I got two.
I got two.
I held up my hand and gave me another one.
He gave me one. And I have the other hand behind my back, but I held up my hand and gave me one. And then he said also, and he said whatever I had to do, he
said,
get me another one.
Today prasadam will be served here, so no one has to go to any other place. Please stay here if you want.
Twice.
There are so many persons.
Okay, you have taken?
Yes, you take.
I'm so glad to have the mother of Chitra.
This is June.
Your teeth are so strong.
आज हम लोग परम सौभाग्यवान हैं। आज हमारे बीच यहाँ के इस स्थान के इस नगरी के मेयर और उनकी धर्मपत्नी यहाँ पर उपस्थित हैं। एक भारतवासी होने पर भी यहाँ पर कोई यह सम्मान मिला है, ये भारतवर्ष का ही सम्मान है। विशेष करके आज इस सभा में हम लोग के परम आराध्य वृंदावन धाम के कृष्ण की लीलाओं के स्थली के उनके सेवक नंदगांव के मंदिर के गोस्वामी जी भी आज उपस्थित। आज हम लोगों को ब्रजवासियों का भी दर्शन करने का सौभाग्य। टुडे आई थिंक दैट वी आर सो फॉर्चुनेट टू बी हियर। आई एम सो ग्लैड I've come to India from India to preach Vedic culture and knowledge. What is Vedas? What is Vedic Gyan? I think that in this Kali Yuga, they are fighting only a rays of asha, hope, that Vedic knowledge and culture can give peace and tranquility in this whole world. To love each other, and it cannot be without. When we love the personality, supreme personality of Godhead, that Krishna and Srimati Radhika ji and Arjuna. He has created this world. He is supporting and nourishing this world. But we are not seen. But the fact is there. So, before my telling anything, I may request Lord Mayor to speak something. And then I, because he will have to go, he has to look somewhere. So I am requesting him to speak something. And then we will do. Then Goswami ji also speak.
Jai Shri Krishna.
Jai.
Swami me and Lady Maris to Prabhupada. We are delighted to be with you in the presence of Srila Narayan Maharaj. Srila Narayan Maharaj is the Vice President of the Shri Gaudiya Vrindata Samadhi, the institution set up by Gurudeva to propagate the message of devotion to Radha and Krishna throughout India. And of course, the first time to Europe and USA, that's why they invited us today. This visit to Europe and USA, as I understand, is the first one. And I welcome you, Srila Narayan Maharaj, to this great city and multicultural city. Now, before I wind up my speech, I may request either for the information of the audience. I being the Lord Mayor for 96 and 97, my appeal for the current year is education for life for young children from the age of 3 to 15. I being a teaching profession myself, the changing lifestyles and the difficult decisions the youngster has to make these days, we have to prepare them for life. We have to educate them about their bodies, the substances that protect them. Physically and psychologically. So it should be their decision, not we should be telling them what is wrong and right. It is for them to decide what is right and wrong for themselves. So my target is to raise £100,000 to buy a mobile, fitted with the latest technology, and around educator who will go from school to school. And in 1 year, about 15,000 children will be covered by this one. We aim it for 3 to 15 years, and your only 10 pounds will give an education to a child for 3 years. So therefore, please, I request you to contribute generously to Lord Mayor's appeal 1996 by 10 pounds. Thank you. So I again want to welcome you, Swami Ji, to Leicester, and we're looking forward to your Padyatra, as I understand, in Leicester. I think you will book a there on the son of Chacha and the Gandhi, you know, Mali Shahako.
Jai Krishna.
Chakshuru Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah. First, I'd like to offer my respectful obeisances to my Gurudev, Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj, and to all the assembled devotees and guests. I'd like to thank all the guests for coming here tonight and for giving us the opportunity of sharing with you the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Lord Krishna, and especially to give you the opportunity to hear from His Divine Grace Srila Narayan Maharaj. And what we are presenting is Vishuddha Dharma, the pure and constitutional inherent dharma or religion of the soul. So our acharyas in the cyclic succession, especially Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he has explained that actually dharma is one that is called Vishuddha Dharma, also known as Sanatana Dharma or Vaishnava Dharma. But in the world today, we see that there are so many different religions going under different designations, such as Christianity, Hinduism, Islam, Judaism, etc., etc., so many. So it appears that there are different dharmas or different religions, but he has explained that in essence there is only one dharma, Vishuddha Dharma, the pure dharma of the soul. But when the living entity comes in contact with this material nature, then his nature becomes adulterated. And then dharma becomes of two types. One is called nirupadi, which means without any designations, and the other is sopadi, which means with designations. So sopadik or sopadi dharma, which means religion, which has different designations, stems from the identification with this body. And it extends into dharma related to family, related to wife, children, so many different dharma, or so many different responsibilities, duties are there in relationship to the body. So this is sopadik dharma. It is not the constitutional dharma of the soul. And when the living entity becomes purified and gradually realizes that he is distinct from this body, he has nothing to do with this material world, he is not a product of the multi-material nature, then he can come under the nirupadik dharma, and that is Sanatana Dharma or Vaishnava Dharma. And in that state, he is able to understand his pure identity in relationship to the Supreme Lord, Bhagavan Sri Krishna. So, in the Vedic literature, it is described, so many different incarnations of the Lord are described there, but the original Supreme Lord is Bhagavan Sri Krishna. And our acharyas have given so much evidence to this fact, especially Srila Rupa Goswami. He has written one book called Laghu Bhagavatamrita, and in this book he has described all the different types of incarnations of the Lord, different types of devotees, the different spiritual dhams, and given their various gradations. So this is a big subject matter, but just to briefly summarize, he has explained that the Swayamrup is the original form of the Lord. And he has defined that as Ananyapekshiyat Rupam Swayamrupas Uchite. So that form, or that manifestation of the Lord, Ananyapekshi, which is not dependent on any other form, that form is called Swayamrup. So that is Bhagavan Sri Krishna. There are so many other manifestations as Swamsha, Vilas, Tadi Katma, Avesh, Lila avatars, Guna avatars, etc., etc. So many different manifestations. But all of these various manifestations, they are all dependent on the original form, Sri Krishna. And only Sri Krishna is not dependent on any other form. Therefore, he is known as Swayamrupa. And one Acharya, Baladeva Jagbhushan, he has given commentary on this shloka of Rupa Goswami, and he has explained, by quoting from the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, how Krishna is the original supreme form. So when Krishna went to Mathura, and he was in the wrestling arena of Kamsa, then so many different residents were there, they were all seeing the form of Krishna, and especially the ladies of Mathura, they were seeing the form of Krishna and appreciating his beauty, and they were expressing the great fortune of the gopis of Braj, who were always able to behold that form, and so they uttered this one shloka, Gopyastapa Kimacharam Yarmushya Rupam Lavanya Saram Asamarvam Ananya Siddham Brigdir Pibanti Anusava Durapam Ekanta Dhamma Yashasa Sriya Aishwarasya. So, in this verse, they are praising the beauty of Krishna. They are saying that the term asamaradvam means that nothing is equal to or greater than the beauty of Krishna. And the gopis, they're saying, what kind of austerities did they perform? Gopyastapakimacharam. What kind of austerities did they perform to have the great fortune of being able to behold this form? Not only behold, but they were drinking that form through the eyes. And they also explain there, Ananya Siddham. Ananya Siddham means that the beauty of Krishna was not dependent on any other on embellishments, on decoration, dress, or anything else. Normally, when a person dresses themselves very nicely with beautiful clothes and ornaments, then their beauty is enhanced. But Krishna's beauty is so extraordinary that his ornaments, his dress, they become beautified in contact with his body. So this is the significance of Ananya Siddham. And Ekanta Dhamma Yashasa Sriya Aishwarasya. His body is the Ekanta Dhamma, means that it is the one and only or the ultimate shelter of these qualities of beauty and opulence and fame. So this verse is confirming Krishna's position as Swayamrupa. And then he also, Rupa Goswami himself, confirms Krishna's identity as Swayamrupa by quoting this verse from Brahma Samhita, Ishvara Parama Krishna Satchitananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. So, Baladeva Jagbhushan Prabhu gives a very wonderful commentary on this. I don't want to take so much time now because I want to give you the opportunity to hear from Srila Narayana Maharaj. But in concluding, we can say that this topmost feature of the Lord, which is his Braj feature, this is our ultimate goal, this is our ultimate destination, is to revive our relationship with Krishna in his feature, in Braj. And this can be done most easily by the association of the residents of Braj, who are steeped in that mood of loving devotion to Radha and Krishna. So we are most fortunate tonight that without going through the great, some great austerity of having to spend so much money and go to Vrindavan and then seek out, even if you go there, you may not be able to find a sadhu or a saint who can actually reveal this knowledge to you. These personalities are extremely rare, but without any endeavor on our part, such a personality has appeared in our midst tonight, and he is the embodiment of this divine love for Radha and Krishna, and by hearing from him, he can awaken this attraction in us to have this love for Radha and Krishna. So please listen very carefully to his words. Hare Krishna.
कृष्णाय नमस्ते मदगोपीजनवल्लभाय नमः मदाचार्य चरण कमलेभ्यो नमः श्री गुरु चरण कमलेभ्यो नमः अज्ञान्तमरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वसुदेव सुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं कान्तिशितामृतनिन्दु कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय हरि परमात्मने प्रणतक क्लेशनाशाय श्री गोविंदाय नमो नमः। परम वंदनीय परमादरणीय श्री विराजमान श्री नारायण स्वामी जी महाराज एवं उपस्थित समस्त वैष्णव वृंद, कृपा क्षमा करना, मैं अंग्रेजी में नहीं बोल सकता। ब्रज भाषा या गुजराती भाषा या पंजाबी भाषा, अन्य भाषाओं में मेरा स्थान है। इंग्लिश का एक कारण था, ये प्रभु जानते हैं, मेरे पिताजी ने मुझको नहीं पढ़ने दिया। जब मैं पढ़ता था तो उन्होंने मुझे मना किया कि ये नहीं पढ़ना। अब ये बहुत प्राचीन बात है, आज से करीबन 50 वर्ष पहली बात कह रहा हूं। उन्होंने मुझे मना किया कि ये भाषा नहीं पढ़नी है, इसे मुझे संस्कृत में डाल दिया। संस्कृत भाषा मैंने पढ़ी, हिंदी पढ़ी, संगीत में मैंने बीए किया म्यूजिक में, और भी अन्य ग्रंथों का अवलोकन किया। एक ही बात आपके सामने प्रस्तुत करता हूं। हमारे श्री स्वामीनारायण जी महाराज और श्री केशव जी इतने महान विभूति हैं, और वो विभूति इतने पढ़े लिखे, इंग्लिश में आपका स्थान है और अन्य भाषाओं पर स्थान है, और धर्म पर पूर्ण स्थान है, इतना होते हुए भी ये ब्रजवास क्यों कर रहे हैं? समस्या ये है। उस ब्रज के विषय में मैं आपको इतना ही कह सकता हूं, भगवान श्री कृष्ण के पास में अर्जुन रहते हुए भी कृष्ण को वो क्या समझते थे, या वो कृष्ण को अपना नौकर समझते थे, या कृष्ण को अपना संबंधी समझते थे, अथवा कृष्ण को अपना संबंधी यानी अपनी बुआ का पुत्र समझते थे, परंतु कृष्ण क्या थे ये जब उनने स्वयं कृपा की, दिव्यम ददामि ते चक्षु पश्चिम योगमेश्वरम, जब तक तुमको मैं दिव्य दृष्टि नहीं देता तब तक तुम मेरे स्वरूप को नहीं देख सकते। इसी प्रकार से जो गुरु होते हैं, जो शासन पर विराजमान होते हैं, जब तक आप सब वैष्णवों को अपनी दिव्य दृष्टि के द्वारा कृपा नहीं करें, तब तक उस परम प्रेममयी ब्रजभूमि का दर्शन नहीं होता। वो ब्रजभूमि क्या है? वृंदे आपि पालितात दिव्य केलि कानने, स्वर्ण रत्न दिव्य गंध मेदुरा बनी थले, दिव्य सत प्रसून रत्न साख मंडला व्रते, छाई आते शोभने मुनिंद ब्रंद लोभने, वह ब्रजभूमि दिव्य है, वहां के वृक्ष आदि सब दिव्य हैं, वहां जो वृक्षों में फल लटके हुए वो सब दिव्य हैं, और उस भूमि को कितना स्थान दिया, उस भूमि को हरेक कोई जान भी नहीं सकता, और उस भूमि में अनेक प्रकार के मणि है, रत्न है, वो सब सुशोभित हैं, परंतु वो सब गुप्त हैं। कोई महान पुरुष कृपा करें तभी हमारे नंदगांव में नित्यानंद जी विराजते थे, शायद आप जानते होंगे, बाबा नित्यानंद जी महान थे, और आज तक वो इतनी संत सेवा करते हैं जिसका कोई वर्णन नहीं। तो ये सब क्यों, ब्रजभूमि का विशिष्ट इतना महत्व कैसे दिया गया? भगवान श्री कृष्ण स्वयं उस ब्रज की पूजा करते थे। स्वामी जी ने, श्री राधिका जी ने यही कहा कि मुझे अगर आपको, मैं चाहती हूं तो मुझे ब्रज में ले जाना चाहते हो तो पहले ब्रज की स्थापना करो, वहां गिरिराज की स्थापना करो, वहां यमुना जी की स्थापना करो, वहां कदम वृक्षों की स्थापना करो, वहां संतों की कुटियों की स्थापना करो, जहां के रूप सनातन, जीव सनातन, गोस्वामी आदि आदि विराज करके हमारा भजन करें। चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी को कह दिया कि आप भी अवतरित होकर के, ये स्वामी जी ने अपनी चुंदरी उनको दी, ठाकुर जी ने अपना पीताम्बर दिया, और दोनों को मिश्रित करके श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी का प्रादुर्भाव हुआ, जो कि चैतन्य महाप्रभु का, क्योंकि वो प्रेम का स्थान था, स्वामी जी प्रेम की स्वरूपा थी, और ठाकुर जी दोनों को मिश्रित करके और श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी पधारे। चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी का विरह, वो दर्शन की, जो चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी कहते हैं, राधा कुंड कृष्ण कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन माधुर माधुर वंशी बाजे यही वृंदावन। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य राधा कुंड कृष्ण कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन माधुर माधुर वंशी बाजे यही वृंदावन। आहरण से अपने कानों में श्री श्याम सुंदर की मुरली को सुनते थे चैतन्य महाप्रभु, और जिस समय उनको ये कह देते कि वृंदावन, उसी समय उनके नेत्र से श्रावण भाद्रपद की तरह वर्षा होती थी नेत्रों से जल की, और उस विरह में इतने डूब जाते थे कि जिसका कोई वर्णन नहीं। उस चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी की परम कृपा में ये एक बड़ी भारी विशेष बात है, वो कोई ऐसी वैसी उन्हीं उसी स्वरूप को लेते हुए श्री स्वामी नारायण जी महाराज जो आपके सामने विराजमान है, वह जो दर्शन था, उनके जो स्वरूप थे, उस स्वरूप का दर्शन कराने के लिए ही आप सब में उपस्थित हैं, और आपके द्वारा आप सब कुछ कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि ब्रज की गति को भगवान तो है ही, आरण से विराजते हैं वैसे नहीं, पर हरेक को वो दर्शन नहीं देते, पर भगवान के स्वरूप में संत लोग पधारते हैं, और उनके द्वारा आप उस परम प्रेम में ही ब्रजभूमि का दर्शन कर सकते हैं। ब्रजभूमि एक यूनिवर्सल है, कॉलेज नहीं, स्कूल नहीं, यूनिवर्सल। वहां के पश्चात फिर जीव को कोई स्थान नहीं रहता, वहां कोई ज्ञान नहीं है, ज्ञान तो वहां वृद्ध पड़ा हुआ है, वहां वैराग्य भी नहीं, वो भी वृद्ध है, परंतु वहां भक्ति जवान है, क्योंकि ये भक्ति मार्ग है। सी जितने भी आचार्य हमारे वृंदावन में हुए ब्रज में, उन्होंने भक्ति का ही प्रचार किया है, और उनको दूसरी बात नहीं, यहां तक बात है, उद्धव इतना ज्ञानी था, और भगवान श्री कृष्ण के पास में रहते हुए भी वो भगवान श्री कृष्ण की भक्ति रूपी बात को नहीं मानते थे उद्धव जी, परंतु जब श्री कृष्ण ने कृपा की तो उनको कहीं नहीं भेजा, उनसे ये नहीं कहा तुम बद्री विशाल चले जाओ, उनसे ये भी नहीं कहा तुम केदारनाथ चले जाओ, उनसे ये भी नहीं कहा तुम रामेश्वर चले जाओ, उनसे कहा कि तुम कहीं मत जाओ, निष्केवल सी ब्रज में जाओ और वृंदावन जाओ, वहां गोपियों के पास में उनका सत्संग करो, वो गोपी जन क्या है, उनके सत्संग के द्वारा ही तुम मुझे जान सकते हो, मैं क्या हूं। इतना सब कुछ पढ़े जिन्होंने बृहस्पति जी से विद्या प्राप्त की, और बृहस्पति जी विद्या प्राप्त करने पर भी भगवान श्री कृष्ण को नहीं समझ सके, भगवान श्री कृष्ण के स्वरूप को नहीं जान सके, उस स्वरूप को जानकारी किसने दी, उन परम प्रेम में ही भुजांगनाओं ने, ब्रज देवियों ने, उस ब्रज भूमि ने। फिर तो उसने यही कह दिया, साफ कह दिया, क्लीन शब्दों में कह दिया कि मुझे कुछ नहीं चाहिए, मुझे तो यही चाहिए, आशा महो चरण रेण दुर्सा महंसाम वृंदावने किवप गुलम औषधी नाम याद सजन स्वजन मार्य पतन चित्वा भेजुर मुकुंद पद्म क्या। दूसरी बात, बंदे नंद ब्रज श्री राम पाद रेणु अभीक्षण सर यासाम हर कथोद गीतम पुनाति भुवन त्रेम। इस त्रिलोकी में कोई ऐसी स्त्री नहीं है जैसी स्त्री ब्रज की गोपी है। आपको पता है हमारे यहाँ चैतन्य महापुरुष जी ने एक इतनी सुंदर प्रणाली का रखी है अपने संतों के लिए, अपने सेवकों के लिए, अपने सेवियों के लिए, कि तुम अपने हाथ से गर्म रोटी मत बनाओ, अपने हाथ से तुम खीर मत बनाओ, अपने हाथ से तुम कुछ मत करो, निष्केवल जाओ ब्रजवासियों के घरों से थोड़ा थोड़ा टुकड़ा मांग करके खाओ, उसी में तुम्हारी भक्ति सफल हो सकती है। ये कोई बड़ी कम बात नहीं है, कितनी बड़ी भारी बात है कि आप वहां जाओ। उन ब्रजवासियों आज भी हमारे ब्रज में नंदगाम, बरसाना, गोवर्धन आदि आदि क्षेत्रों में महात्मा लोग, संत लोग विराजते, हरि नाम जपते, आरण्य शशि चैतन्य महाप्रभु के पास से वो अब भी ब्रजवासी के टूक भूख में खाऊं सांझ सवेरों रात दिन उन टुकड़ाओं को भी इतनी सम्मान करते। अगर रात को बच जाते सुबह छाछ में रोग खाते, और उस टुकड़ाओं के प्रताप से, उन ब्रजवासियों के प्रताप से, उस ब्रज के प्रताप से आज भी उनको प्रिया प्रीतम साक्षात दर्शन देते हैं। यह विशेषता है, ये ब्रज की विशेषता है। इसलिए आचार्य से पधारते हैं केशव जी, नारायण स्वामी जी, और उनका ये एक सिद्धांत है कि तुम कुछ भी उपासना मत करो, निष्केवल एक ही उपासना करो ब्रज की। क्यों? कि एक बार अयोध्या, दो बार द्वारका, तीन बार त्रिवेणी जाकर के नहाओगे, चार बार चित्रकूट, नौ बार नासिक, बार बार बद्रीनाथ घूम के आओगे, कोटि बार काशी, केदार रामेश्वर, गया जगन्नाथ, सब तीर्थ करे आओगे, होते प्रत्यक्ष दर्शन अब वो श्याम सुंदर के, पर वृंदावन सो आनंद तीन लोक नहीं पाओगे। तो परमेश्वर वो शिव वृंदावन है, जहां कहीं भी आप कहीं भी कोई सुख नहीं है। नस्वदेव राजस्य नस्व चक्रीवर्तन ये सुख किंचन मात्र से मुनि एकांत जीवनी। संसार में कहीं सुख है ही नहीं, अगर सुख है तो ब्रजभूमि में है, अगर आनंद है तो ब्रजभूमि में है, अगर संतों का दर्शन करना है तो ब्रज में जाइए, अगर आपको कुछ भी करना है सब कुछ छोड़ दीजिए, निष्केवल एक ही वो वृंदावन जहां आप देखें वहां आपको परम सुख की प्राप्ति होगी। यहां तक बात है, क्या कुसुम सरोवर, क्या गोवर्धन की चारों तरफ तरेटी में आप जाकर के देखें तो वहां आपको सब जगह श्याम सुंदर का दर्शन होगा, प्रिया प्रीतम का दर्शन होगा। वो श्री गोवर्धन की तरेटी जहां पर आज भी ठाकुर जी सदा नित्य नव विराजते, और ये संत लोग अपना घरवार छोड़ करके, ढाका को छोड़ करके, बंगाल को छोड़ करके, नदिया को छोड़ करके, मायापुर को छोड़ करके वो ब्रज में निवास करते हैं। और वहां किसके लिए? निष्केवल कि किसी प्रकार से इस जीवन में हमको एक बार भी श्री कृष्ण मिल जाए, इस जीवन में एक बार भी हमको श्री स्वामी जी का दर्शन हो जाए तो हम अपने को सफलता माने। उन ब्रजवासियों का कितना प्रभाव है, उन ब्रजवासियों का कितना प्रताप है, उन ब्रजवासियों के बीच में रहते हुए भी, और वो इसी कामना से कि किसी प्रकार से उस ब्रजाधीश प्रभु का दर्शन हो जाए, उन मंगलमय श्री प्रिया प्रीतम का दर्शन हो जाए, जिनकी खोज सदैव श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु करते थे, जिनके लिए श्री रूप सनातन, जीव सनातन गोस्वामी जी विराज करके दर्शन करते थे। ये वो ब्रजभूमि है और ये वह ब्रज उपासना है। उस ब्रज उपासना के लिए ही श्री प्रथम बार श्री नारायण स्वामी जी यहाँ पधारे, और आपका सबका बड़ा अहोभाग्य, आप बड़ी भाग्यशाली है। उन्हें ये लोग संत लोग, अरे हम लोगों का इस कंट्री में क्या काम है, विचार को हमको क्या करना है, है क्या जिसके लिए आप है क्या, या कुछ नहीं है, ठंडी खानी है, और इधर उधर की दुकानों में हमारे यहां तो दुकानों में दर्शन करो आपको रबड़ी रसगुल्लाओं के दर्शन हो, यहां क्या है, विचार कीजिए। अगर आप हमारे वृंदावन में जाओ तो आपको क्या रबड़ी, मालपुआ, अनेक प्रकार के पदार्थों का दर्शन होगा, बिहारी जी का दर्शन होगा, राधा लाल जी का दर्शन होगा, सेवा कुंज का दर्शन होगा, निर्वन का दर्शन होगा, यहां क्या है, सी साइड पर चले जाओ क्या रखा है। फिर भी हम लोगों को यहां आना पड़ रहा है, किसके लिए, अपने लिए नहीं, उधर के लिए नहीं, वस्त्र पहनने के लिए नहीं, निष्केवल आप लोगों के लिए, और कोई दूसरा कारण नहीं। आपको यह बता रहे हैं कि आपका जीवन क्या है, आपको यह बता रहे हैं कि आप कहां जा रहे हो, आपको यह बता रहे हैं आप कहां जाओगे, इसे उन सब बातों को बचा करके आपको ब्रज की तरफ आपका पग रखना है, ब्रज में आपको निवास करना है, और हो सकता है अगर आप ज्यादा तपस्वी बने तो ब्रज में बाद में आपको जन्म पद लेना है। वो ब्रजभूमि है, उस ब्रजभूमि का जो महत्व है, इसे आज भी श्याम सुंदर जी जहां आपका आश्रम है सेवा कुंज में, आज भी वहां ठाकुर जी की मुरली सुनाई देती है, और चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी ने इसका अनुभव किया है, और उन्होंने ये कह भी दिया है कि राधा कुंड, कृष्ण कुंड, गिरि गोवर्धन और माधुर माधुर वंशी बाजे, यही वृंदावन। तो परम प्रेमियों, वैष्णवों और स्वामी जी महाराज, बड़े आनंद की बात है, मेरा बड़ा सौभाग्य है कि कितने समय के बाद ब्रज विभूतियों का दर्शन कर रहा हूं। उन्हें यहां कहां ये विभूति मिलती है, बाकी मैं तो अपने आनंद में सेवा करता हूं, सुख में रहता हूं, मुझे कोई बार ठाकुर जी के पास सान्निध्यता मुझे मिली हुई है, पर ऐसे समय में ऐसी ब्रज विभूति जब आती है तो मेरा स्वयं मन हो जाता है कि मैं उनके दर्शन करूं। इतना कहते हुए फिर मैं आपसे कहता हूं कि आप ब्रज की उपासना में संलग्न रहे और जो आपके गुरुदेव के उस आज्ञा को पलते हुए ब्रज उपासना में तत्पर रहे, इतना ही मेरा कहना है। धन्यवाद। हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण
हरि बोल
हरि बोल
हरि बोल।
यकतिं करिष्यामि अनुकाम्यानि नित्यं परस्य पुरुषस्य स्कन्धमौले यस्य पदारसनिधे त्रिशुभां जाय कतके निकुंज भवनं गणमार्जनी। I wanted to speak in Hindi, but I see that there are no Hindi audience.
Not meant to be like that. It wasn't meant to be like that.
May I speak in Hindi?
Yes.
But you know that my English is not so rich. I will speak in Hindi for long. Yes. First I want to explain this sloka, what I did in my Vandana sloka. यतकिं करीष बहुशा खलुकाग बानी नित्यं परस्य पुरुषस्य शिखण्डम। He told about Vraja, so many past times of Christian Srimati Radhika of Braja, Vrindavan, Khandirvan, Nandagaon, Varshana, especially of Radha Gundi, reminded me. So many past. I wanted to tell you something. What is Atma? What is Paramatma? What are the relations? And how we can come out of the unlimited ocean of birth and death, suffering, sorrow. But he demanded, I'm bereaved now. So I'm telling, or I'm explaining first that time. Perhaps you know the name of Srila Prabodhananda Saraswati. He was a learned person and also Rashi and Bhav. He lived in Kamevan, Vrindavan, Bandi. Almost all the parts of Vrindavan. And he was inclined to Srimati Radhika, not to Krishna. He was then with Krishna pastime, Tunga Vidya, one of the aides, Lalita Abhishaka, Kitra, Chandra, Kela, Hindu Lekha, Sudevi, Ramu Devi, and Tunga Vidya. So she is praying like a sadhak ji. Sadhak ji, you know?
Practitioner.
So he is praying in the lotus of feet of Srimati Radhika. Yatakin karishu bhaksha khalu kahaku bhani. Once Srimati Radhika was in anger move to Krishna. We cannot tell anger, but in Sanskrit language it is called man. Man is highest thing. Not this anger in this world, but man, sneh, man, prane, rag, anurag, mahabhav. In that case, when mahabhav, in Srimati Radhika, more than Chandravali also, this Mani Srimati Radhika has this quality. And that is why he stress the four kinds of madhuri, sweetness of Krishna. Rup madhuri, venu madhuri, sweetness of flow, guna madhuri, qualifications. Like he is controlled by gopis, he is Brahma of Brahma, sarva karan karanam, he is Parabrahma, Swayam Bhagavan. But he is controlled by prema. Not only he, breath prema is an embodiment of prema. And all in breath are controlled by that. We may say, so Maya Purnima Devi, who lives in Nandgaon. So, Krishna being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is praying for the mercy of Srimati Radhika. Radhika has some light anger. He has ordered his sakhis, don't allow any black, even bees. They should not enter in my kunj, in my clothes. He may cheat, he may come in the shape of woman, maybe, like gopis he may come. But keep him out of my clothes. Krishna came and he wanted to enter and to meet Srimati Radhika. But Sakhi like Tunga Vidya, like Rupamanjari, they were standing and watching. Any black thing cannot come. Any animal, any bird, bees also. Any gopi wearing the black cloth, black sari, they should not also enter. They should, if they want to come, they should come in yellow colored cloth. What to do? This hair is not black, they should be covered. Otherwise they should be checked there. So anything black should not come. Krishna was stopped there. Krishna asked that, I want to meet Srimati Radhika. I want to please Radhika. So please order us, me, to enter the Kunj groves. They said, no, we cannot allow. Or Swamini Ju, means Radhika, has ordered us. So we cannot let you enter in the groves. 100 times, he gave his head to a lot of feet of gopis, where the kinkaris of Srimati Radhika, kinkari means? But you should know that in Vrindavan Braja, no kinkari dashi, all are sakhi. No servant there, like in this world. वहाँ पर जगत जैसी दासियाँ नहीं हैं, वहाँ सभी सखियाँ हैं, सभी मित्र हैं, all are like friends. Krishna, no one does any pranam to Krishna there. Krishna may take the duty. Nanda Baba ka shoe of Nanda Baba on his head. And Arani, sometimes giving here, oh, this is my father's shoe. And he glad, he comes to our mother, his mother. Maya, ye Baba ka duty hai. Baba ki duty hai. So, Gopi checked him. He was like weeping, praying so much, giving his head to the Lord feet of Gopis. But they are joking to Krishna. You will do again? So if the power of Gopis are such high, what we can tell the glory of Srimati Radhika? Oh Radhike, oh Swami Ji, I don't want the mercy of Krishna. By the power of mercy of yours, I don't recognize Krishna. But I know that he is your very much beloved. So I have some relation. No direct relation, but relation that your beloved is Krishna and you are my Swami. You are my Swami. So, he is praying to the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. O Radhike, I want to be one stick of groom.
Broom.
That will be used for sweeping the growth of Srimati Radhika. I know that I am not qualified to serve him as a sakhi, but being the stick of a broom, I can serve the growth of Srimati Radhika, where he serves Krishna, and Krishna Radha meets there. We are not qualified to hear all these things, but yet I get some outline. What is Braja? Who are Gopis? Who is Krishna? Krishna is endless ocean of rasa. Kya kya kaha? Krishna akhil rasamrit sindhu hai. We want to only play on the web, sinking and going up on that ocean. If Srimati Radhika, even one drop, not drop,
only
sprinkle of that ocean, one very little particle, then our life will be successful. For this, we'll have to follow Siddha Rup Goswami, Siddha Raghunath Goswami. For this, we'll have to go through Srimad Bhagavatam, Nigamakalpatarurgalitarnaphalam, Sukhamukhad Amritrasanjutam, Vivat Bhagavatam Rasamalayam, Mohrao Rashika Bhubhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself told and explained this sloka. Aradho Bhagavan Priti Satanayastat Dhamma Vrindavanam Ramya Kachit Upasana Vajubadu Bargaina Jatalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Amalam Prema Pumartho Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam Satpradaro Nahapara. How beautiful. I have explained so many places this is Lokas. all this world, but yet I am touching. Prachakabarti Chakri is telling, Aradho Bhagavan Prajesh Satanaya. Krishna has so many manifestations. Narayana is also Bhagavan. Golokpati Krishna is also Bhagavan. Sri Ramachandra is also Bhagavan. Dwarkadhi is also. Mathuresh Krishna is also Bhagavan. But they are not Swayam Bhagavan. Tattvata, by Tattva, they are same thing. Same thing. But Rasagat Bhava, in Ras, according to Ras, Prajendanandan, Shyam Sundar, Radhikaraman, is only Supreme Personality of Bhagavan Swayam. Srimad Bhagavat declares it so apparently that Brajendanandan Shyam, not Dwarkadhish, not Rukminina, only Radha Kamsa, Brajendanandan Shyam, having float here and three-folded, so beautiful, and how kind and merciful that even Putana went to murder Krishna and to take the flesh and blood of Krishna. He gave Dhatri Uchitagati, like mother, Oho Vakinyam Kanakari. So, our highest object of love is Krishna. But who Krishna? Bhajendanandan Shyam Sundar. Especially Gopi Kanta, especially Radha Kanta, Radha Raman, controlled by Gopis. Vrindavan is the same thing. These are the past times of Krishna. So, Vrindavan is same thing as Krishna. Rajendranandan Shyam Sundar Aradha. And the same way, Vrindavan is Aradha. Why? Krishna has become himself Vrindavan, non different to Vrindavan Krishna. Vrindavan is not different to Krishna, because Baldev has become that dham. And he serves Krishna as Vrindavan. So, Vrindavan is the abode of that Krishna, who is ocean of Rasa. And the highest devotional service to Krishna, what is that rendered by gopis? Not by Hanuman, not by Pandava, not even by Uddhava, not even by Rukmini and Satyabhama. What to tell of Kubja Devi? So, we should know all these things. Who was Krishna? What is Vrindavan? He told the glorification of Vrindavan. Prabhadanand Saraswati has written so many slokas in Vrindavan Mahima Amrita. So, Uddhava has also told regarding this. So, the highest prem to Krishna was rendered by gopis. And this is the goal, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to preach. Anarpita charing chirat karnaya atirna kalau samarpai tamanna tajjal rasam swabhakti shiyam hari hapura sundar dhut kadam prasandhita sadar idaya kandare prutmi sachinanta. He also told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Who are Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Why he came? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Himself Lord Krishna. Not Lord Krishna. He was himself Vrajendanandan, Radharam. He wanted to fulfill his wishes. But his object of love is not container. Which container? Srimati Radhika container. प्रेम के विषय कृष्ण हैं और आश्रय सबसे सर्वोत्तम आश्रय श्रीमती राधिका जी हैं जो कृष्ण की समस्त आकांक्षाओं को अभिलाषाओं को पूर्ण करती है. सी सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ पावर एनर्जी एंड लव एंड अफेक्शन सी कैन पेंट द थर्ड ऑफ थर्ड ऑफ कृष्ण. All what Krishna will wish at once she will do. Anyone cannot do. Anyone cannot do. Ma Yashoda cannot do. Nanda Baba cannot do. Anyone cannot do. Malli Srimati Radhika. So the highest upasana is of Srimati Radhika. It cannot be given to anyone, but some three of that thing. Shobha, Unnata Ujjal Ras. The service of Srimati Radhika is called Unnata Ujjal Ras. And only a particle of that serve like Manjari. He can stop. Only we cannot take the mood of Srimati Radhika, but we can serve Srimati Radhika. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come, Krishna has come, having the mood of Srimati Radhika and having the beauty of Radhika, golden collar. He came to, mercifully, he has descended to this world to give the particle of Unnat Ujjala Rasa. Unnat Ujjala Rasa is Parikiya Bhava. Madhujya Bhava. He has come to particle thing. So, Srimad Bhagavat has told like this. Bande Nanda Brajeshtri Nang Padrenum Abhikshna Sarsana Jasam Harikotodhuni Punat Gonatne Uthava has read like this. He has told that Bande Brajan, Bande Nanda Braja Istrina, Padarenu. Here, if you knew Sanskrit, that then you can understand something. Here, Padarenu is similar number. Why ek vachan? Less and less gopi are there. Unnumerable gopis are there. And a dust cannot be counted of any one gopi's lotus feet. But he has told here, I want to do bandana of one particle of a dust. Where is that dust? This dust is of the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. जो धूल है उनकी तो लाखों हैं, उनकी गंदा गिरना नहीं हो सकती. एक गोपी के चरण धूली भी, किंतु ये एक की वंदना कर रहे हैं क्यों? Why he is doing one very little dust, Vandana Hebrew. This dust must be of Srimati Radhika's dust. Brahma has prayed in his Vandana. Tarbhul Bhaktriha Janam Kimapatapyam Jadgokle. Brahma has told that I'll be so fortunate. Be anywhere in world or in this Vrindavan. Even in Gokul, I want to be a stone. If I am not qualified to be any person in Vrindavan, I have not done anything for that, I am not qualified for that. But I want to be a stone placed there, where in Gokul. And the sweeper who take the tools of persons and throw it here and here. Maila kamane wali, jamadarni. Jamadarni ho karke bhi jadi aaun. और जमदारनी भी मैला कमा करके आकर के अपने चरणों को वहां पर रगड़ दे पानी दे करके लाइक दिस
जीवन लाभ जाती
है तो मैं वो पत्थर का वो पत्थर बनना चाहता हूं जो कि वो जमदारनी अपने पैरों को रगड़ करके अपने चरण की दूरी हमारे पर मैं एंड सो आई विल बी सो लकी फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव द डस्ट ऑफ दैट वेरी वेरी लो classes of that woman who takes the tools on her head and throws them. I want to be. To have the dust of that. But Uddhava is telling not, I don't want to be that. I want to be in Braja. And in Braja, gopi with dust. And especially of Srimati Radhika Bande. Nanda Braja Istvinam Pad Renum forever, forever. I don't want anything. I don't want the fruit dust of Krishna. I want nothing. Only I want to be the dashi of Mati Radhika. If it is not giving, then I want to be the fruit dust of. I want to pray the fruit dust of. The dashis of Srimati Radhika. So much highest thing in Srimad Bhagavatam. The object, main object, an object of the life is this. And for this, to have back to ground, and that ground will come from Srimad Bhagavad Gita. सर्वधर्मानुपरित्यज्य मामेकं सर्वं अहं त्वां सर्वपापेभ्यो मुक्षयिष्यामि मा शुचि विल हैव टू सरेंडर फुल्ली सरेंडर फ्रॉम हार्ट माइंड सोल एवरीथिंग बट वेर इज कृष्ण वेर विल फाइंड कृष्ण वेर इज ऑल सो His messenger, like Guru Devi, is here in front of us. We can first surrender into the lotus feet of Guru Devi. He is none different from Baldev Shukha. Nityananda Guru. Mercifully he will take us to the lotus feet of Krishna in Vrindavan Braja. This is Bandhi. So, we should remember all these things and try to develop our Krishna consciousness for all these things. We will not only win the first class A, B, C, D. We have to go up and down. So, we'll have to follow first Gita, that we are not this body, material body. We are the part and parcel of Krishna. Jive Sarupa Hai Nitya Krishna Das Yunupa Hai Sarupa. we are disturbing eternal subject of Krishna by our Swarup. Now we are being transferred. Now we are thinking that this body is mine. But one day it will be old, it will be old and torn, and this body will be burnt into ashes or will be given in earth, grave, and there will be so many insects there, and if both are not done, then dogs or jackals will come and very patiently they will and they are quite public. This is mine, he will tell that man, this is mine. So these are the end of this body. So we should try to realize, who am I? Ketana Mahapurusha. We are the servant, eternal servant of Krishna by your soul. And if this is finished, then postgraduate book is Srimad Bhagavatam. You will be qualified to enter in Bhagavad. Without finishing the lessons of Bhagavad Gita, Jagyasat Karmano, Lokamanatra Karma Bandana, Tadvidhi Pranipatena, Pariprasnena Sevaya. From beginning. We are in beginning. Myself in is also beginning. I am among you. I know something, but it's not realized. So, you are all Vaishnav. Now the time is over. Some kirtan will be done. So many things were to tell. But no time. And if some time, but I cannot speak more because I am old, too old. Dr. Sir ordered me not to speak more than 30 minutes.
Oh.
But I don't follow. I think we want to speak something and be glad to. Gaur Premanande, Jai Jai Sri Radhe, Jai Jai Sri Radhe.
Hare Krishna, everybody. We understand that Vrindavan is our Maharaj has spoken to you. Actually, Maharaj has come to deliver Vrindavan to us. He asked me to tell you that he hasn't come to ask for anything, he's actually come to deliver pure love of Krishna, which is very wonderful. Unfortunately, I'm on a different mission, slightly different mission. I've come to ask for something. I've come to ask for your help, your mercy. I work with a project here in Leicester called Friends of Vrindavan. You heard some of the glories of Vrindavan today from Maharaj. We are trying to do some work in Vrindavan to restore its original beauty. When we read the Srimad Bhagavatam, we hear the glories of Krishna, we hear the glories of Vrindavan, how wonderful it is. With pure eyes we can see the Chintamani, we can see Vrindavan is in fact non-different from the spiritual world. But unfortunately my position is not so elevated. So when I go there I see that the trees have been cut down, that there is no proper water to drink. That actually, Maharaj told me, even small children, they do not have proper food. And he asked, what can we do? And when he told me that, I remember that Srila Prabhupada used to always tell us about the blind man and the lame man. That here in the West we are spiritually blind. But in India, in Vrindavan, there is some lameness, some material lameness. But together we can cooperate to do something wonderful. So we are trying to arrange to raise some funds to restore Vrindavan. So I've come here today to ask you, we are organizing one expedition from Yamunotri down to Vrindavan in October. And we're trying to get everybody to help us out, to contribute something. You can see we have some panels here about the work that we're doing. And there'll be one or two devotees who perhaps
can tell you a little bit more about it. I don't want to take up more of your time, distract you from the kirtan. But I would ask you to look around and take 1.5 forms and see if you can do something. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Other gate one. प्रसाद लेके जाए
नहीं मैं
नहीं मैं
प्लीज एवरीबॉडी हरे कृष्ण वुड यू लाइक टू गो टू द अदर रूम टू टेक प्रसाद एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर कमिंग टुनाइट हरे कृष्ण
ओके चलो नहीं चाहिए.